gotta stay high till I die. I gotta stay high till I die. I gotta stay high till I die. I gotta stay.
Hello everybody, how's it going? It's C-RadTV, and welcome to another edition of Deeetroit Pistons Monthly, the November 2019 edition. So now with the first official real month of NBA basketball officially in the book, let's go through the Pistons and let's see how they did in the month of November. So in the month of November, the Pistons went 4-10. Oh god, that's bad. The Pistons' only wins came against the Brooklyn Nets, the New York Knicks, the Atlanta Hawks, and the Orlando Magic. The Pistons entered December 6-13. They are 11th in the Eastern Conference, 3rd in the Central Division. They are 10.5 games behind the division-leading Milwaukee Bucks. And they're a game and a half out of the 8th and final playoff spot being held by the Heat. The Pistons, they're 2-8 in their last 10 games, and they entered December on a 2-game losing streak. The Pistons also are currently 8th in the draft order. But yeah, that's just a brutal start. Bad stretch, bad month for the Pistons at the start of the year. Part of that was because Blake Griffin was injured most of the month. And they're dealing with other injuries, too, like to Reggie Jackson, too. And they had some injuries from D-Rose. But, yeah. Overall, in total, though, the Pistons, they had 1,492 points in November, averaging around 106.6 points a game. Pistons gave up 1,512 points in November, averaging around 108 points allowed per game. Their field goal percentage in November was 46.1%. Their three-point percentage was 38%. Their free throw percentage was 74.4%. So yeah, they really got to work on their shooting a little better, especially free throws. Free throws should be a lot better than that. Same deal with 3 points. They got to be better. Like, Pistons got to be better shooting the ball. And overall as a whole. Pistons had 594 rebounds in November, averaging 42.4 rebounds a game. Pistons also had 135 rebounds in November, offensive rebounds in November, averaging 9.6 offensive rebounds a game. Pistons had 352 assists in November, averaging 25.1 assists per game. Pistons had 89 steals in November, averaging 6.4 steals a game. Pistons had 78 blocks in November, averaging 5.6 blocks a game. Pistons also had 209 turnovers in November, averaging 14.9 turnovers a game. So Pistons gotta, you know, they gotta get better at controlling the ball. You know, they're getting slowly better, but, you know, there's always room to improve. The Pistons had 678 points in the paint in November, averaging 48.4 points in the paint per game. Pistons also had 179 second chance points in November, averaging 12.8 second chance points a game. Pistons also had 178 fast break points in November, averaging 12.7 fast break points per game. Pistons also got 217 points off turnovers in November, averaging 15.5 points off turnovers per game. So the Pistons are making the most of the points they're getting. They just need to work on it a little more. You can try and get some more off of it. The Pistons throughout November, the biggest average lead they had in each game was around 9.9 points a game. So Pistons are on average had a 9 or 10 point lead in at least every game, or close to it, around there. So Pistons, you know, they gotta be better defensively. They gotta learn how to hold on to a lead and finish these games. Pistons, they had 280 personal fouls in November, averaging 20 personal fouls a game. So they gotta be better disciplined You know, Dwayne Casey's got to get him better discipline. And the Pistons only had 3 technical fouls in November, averaging 0.2 technical fouls a game. So offensively, the Pistons got to be able to shoot better, and defensively, they got to clean a few things up. And, you know, they just got to make the most of the opportunities they get, and they got to, you know, finish the games. Because a lot of the games the Pistons had this month, they had a shot to win. A lot of them, there should have been wins, but the Pistons just couldn't finish the job. You know, they got to be able to finish these games because they're losing a lot of games they should be able to win, no problem. In terms of player stats, Markieff Morris, he had 145 points in November, averaging 10.4 points a game. He also had 49 rebounds in November, averaging 3.5 rebounds a game. He also had 23 assists in November, averaging 1.6 assists per game. Tony Snell, he only played in 10 games due to injury, but he had 93 points in those 10 games, averaging 9.3 points a game. He also had 18 rebounds in November, averaging 1.8 rebounds a game. And he had 12 assists in November, averaging 1.2 assists per game. Andre Drummond, he had 227 points in November, averaging 16.2 points a game. So he had a bit of an off month from what he normally is. So, you know, hopefully he can get back on it. He had 238 rebounds in November, averaging 17 rebounds a game. And Andre Drummond had 41 assists in November, averaging 2.9 assists per game. Shut up, phone. I'm trying to record, goddammit. Tim Frazier, he only played in 5 games due to injury and being complete garbage. He had only 8 points in November, averaging 1.6 points a game. He also had 4 rebounds in November, averaging 0.8 rebounds a game. Same total for his assists. 4 assists and 0.8 assists per game. Congratulations. You have just reached numbers that Bruce Brown could only fucking dream of. You are officially the worst player on the Pistons by a country mile. God damn it, I thought Bruce Brown was bad. This is just outright pathetic. Can we just get rid of him already and get somebody else in? No? Damn it. Anyway, moving on. Luke Kennard, he had 242 points in November, averaging 17.3 points per game. A lot of games he did start, he actually got double-digit points. Holy shit, he actually learned how to score while being a starter. Because he's always been a lot better on the bench than as a starter. Damn. Maybe Luke Kennard can get it done as a starter. He just needs to be more consistent. Kennard, he also had 55 rebounds in November, averaging 3.9 rebounds per game. He also had 65 assists in November, averaging 4.6 assists per game. Next, we get to Bruce Brown. Bruce Brown in November had 118 points in November, averaging 8.4 points per game. Holy shit, hey, Bruce Brown can actually do something. He actually can play basketball offensively. And he's good defensively. Holy shit. Has Bruce Brown finally turned a corner in his development? Can he actually be a top player on the Pistons? We'll have to see. He needs to be more consistent for me to be sold on him. Bruce Brown, he did have 56 rebounds in November, averaging 4 rebounds per game. And Bruce Brown also had 66 assists in November, averaging 4.7 assists per game. He can actually do things now. Hooray. Maybe he could be more consistent then. But anyway, moving on. Blake Griffin, he was on and off throughout the month of November due to injury and just getting rest, making sure he's 100%. Because he tried to rush it and it's not working. Don't rush it, Blake. Come back when you're 100%. So in total, Blake only played in 7 games in November. He had 138 points, averaging 19.7 points per game. Had 36 rebounds, averaging 5.1 rebounds per game. And he had 23 assists, averaging 3.3 assists per game. Like I said, Blake, Don't rush it. Come back when you're 100%. Don't try and rush it. But he might now actually be 100% because now he's been officially removed off the injury list. So maybe Blake Griffin can get his numbers back to when he normally is, back in the 20s. But yeah, moving on. Derrick Rose, he was also on and off throughout the month with injuries. He only played in 9 games. He had 132 points in November, averaging 14.7 points per game. D Rose also had 18 rebounds, averaging 2 rebounds a game. And he had 43 assists, averaging 4.8 assists per game. He also got some time as a starter, because it turned out making Derrick Rose come off the bench might have been a big mistake, and that he was playing at a starter caliber level. Like, seriously, why the fuck was he not a starter to begin with? Like, that shit makes no sense. But anyway, continuing on, Langston Galloway, he had 190 points in November, averaging 13.6 points per game. He also had 29 rebounds in November, averaging 2.1 rebounds per game. And Galloway had 27 assists, averaging 1.9 assists per game. Sibby Mikhaiuk, he only played in 13 games. He was benched for one, you know, due to coach's decision. Because, you know, he got a lot of young talent on the team, you know, at just very little time. But Mikhaiuk, he had 54 points in November, averaging 4.2 points per game. He had 15 rebounds in November, averaging 1.2 rebounds per game. And Mikhaiuk had 17 assists, averaging 1.3 assists per game. Now, some solid production out of Mikhaiuk. Could do a little better, you know, but hey, you know, he's very young. He's got a long way to go in his development, but the kid's got to step up. You know, he needs more playing time so that he can get to his max potential. And Christian Wood, he played in 13 games. Of course, he didn't play in one because of coach's decision. So, in November, Christian Wood had 95 points in November, averaging 7.3 points per game. He had 53 rebounds in November, averaging 4.1 rebounds per game. And he only had 6 assists, averaging 0.5 assists per game. Like, Christian Woods had been a really solid producer off the bench. You know, he's been really solid, you know. He just needs more time. I think he should get some more playing time. You know, so he can get up to his max potential. You know, got to be more consistent. And, of course, in terms of injuries, Kyrie Thomas, he's out for the foreseeable future with a foot injury. Damn, that's a bad break for him. And Reggie Jackson, he's been day-to-day game-time decision with the back injury. I think the Reggie Jackson back injury, that's really killing the Pistons this year. One of the big contributors to the Pistons' downfall this year. Because, you know, Pistons, they should be a lot better than the record says, but, you know, they lost a lot of winnable games that should have been wins. You know, a couple injuries to key players is the big contributor. But I think when Reggie does come back, the Pistons should be able to turn around. Like, you know, they might be struggling at the start of the year, but they still got plenty of time to turn around. But yeah, that's going to wrap it up here for the November 2019 edition of Deeetroit Pistons Monthly. So, of course, we enter December, the final month of 2019, before we head into the 2020s, the turn of the decade. So, yeah, overall, the Pistons, you know, like I mentioned before, they got a few things to clean up defensively. Offensively, they got to do better with their shooting. Like, they got to be better shooting the ball. You know, they got to be better disciplined, you know, just clean some basic stuff up. You know, Reggie comes back, you know, a lot of these losses should turn into wins. When they got to learn how to finish these games. You know, and players off the bench have to come in for anyone that gets injured. They got to step up, plain and simple. But yeah, anyway, I think I gave my thoughts here on the Pistons in November. That's going to wrap it up here for another edition of Deeetroit Pistons Monthly. That's all I got to say, folks. Hope everyone has a great day, and yeah, peace out.
Oh, there's a goal! Oh, defense!